Hello everyone, I am Dr. Saurabh Mani Tripathi and you are watching my YouTube channel Double E Lectures. The topic of this short lecture is Direct Current Machines, Condition for Maximum Mechanical Power. Before establishing the condition for maximum mechanical power developed by the DC motor, first recall from my preceding video lecture that for both separately excited and shunt excited DC motors, we have the voltage across the armature ends, that is VA, being the same as that of terminal voltage VT. Consequently, the current voltage relationship for these two sorts of DC motors is typically expressed as VA is equal to EB plus IARA. Similarly, for the cases of series excited as well as short shunt and long shunt compound DC motors, the current voltage relationship is typically expressed as VT is equal to EB plus IARA plus ISERSE, where symbols have their usual meanings. Rearranging this equation, we have VT minus ISERSE is equal to EB plus IARA. Remember that we may express the terms VT minus ISERSE as the voltage across the armature ends, that is VA. Hence, the current voltage relationship for these three sorts of DC motors is also expressed as VA is equal to EB plus IARA. So, now based on these discussions, we have a typical current voltage relationship for any DC motor as VA is equal to EB plus IARA. Upon multiplying both the sides by IA, we have VAIA is equal to EBIA plus IA square RA. Now recall, the first term in this equation is nothing but the power input to the armature of the DC motor, while the third term represents the power loss in the armature circuit. And therefore, the second term signifies the mechanical power developed by the armature of the DC motor. Now, write once again the power equation as VAIA is equal to EBIA plus IA square RA, representing the mechanical power developed by the armature of the DC motor, that is second term of the power equation, as PM. We may rewrite the power equation as PM is equal to VAIA minus IA square RA. Now, the condition for maximum mechanical power developed by the DC motor can be established by putting the first order derivative of PM with respect to armature current IA equal to 0. This implies VA minus 2IARA is equal to 0. This would result in IARA is equal to VA by 2. However, it is worth noticeable that exploring a point, whether it is a maximum or minimum, can be established by means of the second order derivative. Therefore, we have to determine the second order derivative of PM with respect to armature current IA. The second order derivative of PM with respect to IA is calculated as minus 2RA, which clearly is negative. Thus, power maximum is concluded here. Now, coming back to the condition for maximum mechanical power developed by the DC motor, we may substitute the value of IARA in typical current voltage relationship, that is VA is equal to EB plus IARA. Accordingly, we may now express the condition for maximum mechanical power developed by the DC motor as EB is equal to VA by 2. This way, we may now state the mechanical power developed by the DC motor would be maximum when the back EMF EB is equal to half of the voltage applied across the armature ends, that is VA. However, It is worth interesting to know we never aim at achieving this condition practically. This is mainly due to two reasons. The first one is this condition would result in excessive armature current in the DC motor. That is, the armature current in the DC motor would be much more than its rated value. And number two, half of the input power to the armature would be wasted as heat. Therefore, the efficiency of the motor will go down to less than 50%. The topic of DC machine efficiency would be covered in my next video lecture. So keep watching and do like this video and subscribe my channel. Please don't forget to share your learning experiences on this short video lecture. Thanks for watching. Goodbye.